because the debate is currently on the remuneration of teachers, fuel prices have hit the 6,000 Uganda shillings mark, and analysts are warning that with the Kenyan election only a month away, this could get worse. For now, the government has been advised to think about stocking fuel in order to save millions of Ugandans who could soon part with 7,000 shillings per litre. Welcome to the show. Here now are some of the stories that made the business week. Government resumes search for Uganda Airlines CEO. 38.8 billion Uganda shillings to be reinvested in Uganda Development Bank to build capital stocks. Bank of Uganda to start regulating circles. Uganda-South Sudan launch joint business forum. Heathrow Airport announces more flight cancellations. And non-essential petrol sales halted for 2 weeks in Sri Lanka. Welcome to the show. For years now, tourism has been looked at as an income earner for governments and for tour operators. This means that the sites have to be protected at every cost. There is a twist, however, where some operators are advocating for what's known as sustainable tourism. In this case, there is protection of sites, but also benefits for people that are living around them. In Views from the Top this week, we speak to Boniface Byamukama, the chairman, Exclusive Sustainable Tour Operators Association, on how this will change the face of tourism in times like these, especially when tourist numbers are dropping.
I'm called Boniface Byamukama. I'm the chairman of a new association called Exclusive Sustainable Tour Operators Association. In a brief, it is called the STOA. This is a new association mainly focusing on sustainable travel, conservation, and local benefits through tourism to the local community around the national park and the Ugandans at large. The tourism sector also moves with changes. You might have heard the COP26 that took place in Glasgow. The main focus was sustainability, and it's no longer tourism as usual. It has now different dimensions and new additions, and how to position a destination as a sustainable tourism destination, and not business as usual anymore. Post-COVID, it's a challenge. It will not be the same as before. A lot of changes will happen, which have happened, the increase of airfares, especially destination to Uganda. Also, the dynamics how the tourism is being run now. There are also other forces, especially like the war in Ukraine is also affecting. You might have had some flights have to move a longer distance because the airspace in Russia is not allowed. That means the tourists have to pay more money for the flight. And also, there is almost a credit crunch in some of our source markets. So there is a challenge both locally and in our source markets. So we don't anticipate to have a full scale, full house, fully booked lodges very soon. Of course, there are some tourists who are coming in, but not to that number that we used to have before COVID. There are so many forces, but what we are doing is to eliminate plastics in our system, in our itinerary, and also to our destination lodges, because we have realized that plastic caveras are a problem to some of our national parks. So we are encouraging tourists come with their own water bottle. Then we have bigger cans that we can use to refill these bottles of water for tourists consume. We are also looking at the elimination of carbon print issues. We have now started the campaign. Every tourist a tree, or every tourist must plant a tree. We have done a partnership with one of the local communities near Chibale National Park, where every tourist who tracks the chimpanzees is able to plant a tree. And this project is going on very well. We are now in the discussion with the Uganda Wildlife Authority to start doing tree planting in Mount Elgon. You might have heard of what happened some time back regarding Bududa. So we have a lot of stakeholders' engagements, especially those who own lodges around the parks, to encourage them to do things that conserve nature. And I'm happy to report that most of the lodges around the parks, they are interested in our message. In 1 week's time, we shall be in Lake Mburo meeting some of the lodge owners in order to introduce this sustainable tourism concept into the service providers. And our association, it's only not for tour operators, but anybody who is involved in tourism, a safari guide, a lodge owner, name it, and we shall also be in the process of contacting the Ministry of Transport and Works, especially the public buses that continue to throw rubbish and the water bottle outside the window when they are traveling on the highways. And I would like to also to inform Ugandans that this country is ours and we should protect it. Don't go throw plastic bottles all over the place, in the bus, in a taxi. Let us try to conserve our country, Uganda. Of course, the cost of living will impact on our sector. When you talk about domestic tourism, you are talking about who has somebody, an individual, have saved some money to go and visit, for example, Queen Elizabeth National Park. And that is an extra expenditure. So people are now cautious about what they spend on. But there are those who, few cases who feel that I also need to go for a holiday to relax. Tourism is, or going for a tour, is not about luxury. It is about well-being of your body, where you can sit alone and enjoy nature, run out of this noise of Kampala. So, and it is good for you, even to relax your mind so that you can go on this holiday, you go there and sing, and then maybe you can even bring a new work methodology on your table when you come back to the office. So it is about relaxing your mind, not necessarily enjoyment. During Easter, most of the national parks were busy, fully booked, and we also anticipate that the coming Christmas we shall have this scenario. We are in partnership with Uganda Tourism Board, the Uganda Wildlife Authority, to do this promotion so that the people are aware that this is available. But I doubt, yes, of course, the high cost of living affects us as a sector, but we are talking not more than 50%. So, but the 50% we can handle.
Yo You're still watching the Business Show, and as a tour operator and anyone else involved in tourism, this information could help you navigate the tough times right now. Let's now take a short break. The Business Show returns shortly.